Good afternoon and welcome back. This is the concluding face-to-face interaction session for this course. Of course, the course, as you know, will continue up to 12th of November, and there will be material that will be released next week and so on. I am here personally to say a few things on this occasion of the closure. First of all, I would like to compliment all the students for sparing their time. I have personally interacted with several students in some 20 remote centers. As I mentioned in the morning, I'll be visiting Indore, and I'll be visiting at least two or three remote centers and interacting with these students. But the feedback has been that all students find this course very meaningful. In this context, I would like to advise you that we will be conducting a common survey for both the courses. This survey will be released next week along with the other material. While the qualification for certification has been stipulated as getting so many marks, etc., the survey has no marks, but it is obligatory. That means every student must submit that survey. Please note that such surveys tell us a whole lot of things about you, about the course, and such survey feedback permits us to take corrective actions. Please note that the survey will be conducted exactly the way we conduct our feedback in IIT Bombay for the courses that we teach. So all surveys are anonymous. That means who said what is not known to us. However, our system does record whether somebody has submitted the survey or not. So we will know those who have not submitted the survey, and as I said, they may not be qualified to get a certificate at the end. But it is not the certificate. It is the value that you bring back to us through your feedback, which is very, very critical. So please give that survey along with doing other things. The second thing I would like to mention is that the feedback that I have already received from many people, particularly from students of other colleges which are not remote centers, they also want to participate and benefit from this program. So while we will run the financial literacy course next semester, along with the technical skills for solving large problems, these will be two courses of 4 weeks each, 4 to 5 weeks each. But simultaneously, we will be conducting a repeat of the combination of this course, which we'll be calling Soft Skills and Introduction to Workplace Communication. This will be a composite course for about 6 weeks. This will not be a free course, of course. There'll be a fees. We'll announce the fees. There is a feedback question on that. We'll like to find out what students believe is reasonable. But we would like to open it up to a larger number of remote centers. We'll be starting that registration process. We have so many requests. We will probably restrict it to about 5,000 colleges. Not all colleges will have these interactive facility. The interactive facilities would be limited to about 200 to 250 colleges at a time, and we might have different slots. But we believe that this course brings value to these students, which enables these students to become better prepared for their future life. I have already thanked all of you because this was a pilot program. JP Morgan colleagues have helped us. But primarily, the course was coordinated and moderated in IIT Bombay by our faculty colleagues. And the team led by Professor Parsathi has done an excellent job. So I would like to take this opportunity to thank him profusely and his colleagues. And we expect you to continue helping us in the subsequent editions of the program as well. I must also thank the workshop coordinators, so the teachers nominated by the institutions. They had to go an extra mile because in addition to their normal teaching load, they had to participate in the activities. Let me assure them that we are as grateful to them as we are to the other faculty colleagues here. And in fact, they will have more targeted and defined work in the subsequent editions of this program. So in conclusion, I would like to thank one and all for active participation. Although this is the last interactive session, please note that this is not the closure of the course. The course will close in its due course, which is on 12th of November. Please ensure that you give the quizzes in time. Please ensure that you go through the online material in time. Just as online activity is not a substitute for face-to-face interaction, similarly, the face-to-face interaction or individual and group activities in the college are not a substitute for studying the material properly and going through the short video lectures or learning dialogues, as we call them. Please do both. Enjoy the course and be better prepared for the future. Thank you so much. I'll hand over to Professor Parsathy now.
So while Professor Phatak is here, I would like to just say one or two things. So firstly, I would like a round of applause for Professor Phatak and the entire team here put in enormous efforts, weekdays, weekends, daytimes, nighttime, because they had to work with clockwork precision to ensure that all the material reaches you as per the deadline. Every Tuesday at 12 o'clock, the material is up there. I don't think there was ever a lapse. So they've put in a lot of effort. So my team, the faculty, the team, technical team here, Professor Phatak, for offering this course. I would like to thank all of them. I would also like you all to give a round of applause to yourselves also. Yes. Because you need to be appreciated for taking this first step. You know, the outcomes will come, but it is only if you put in the effort that you will reach those goals. So the fact that so many thousands of you have chosen to enroll for this course and have seen the videos, given the quizzes, read the material, and then turned up every 2 weeks to ask questions, that really motivates us. As faculty, we want nothing more than students who are interested in what we have to teach. And we were very happy when the first ever question, the comment in the earlier session, the student from Solapur said that they have a lot of respect for us. You know, we don't need anything more. Okay, so thank you very much. So we will now get to the concluding session of this workplace communication.
Thank you.
So this is our concluding session. Once again, to remind you, this is the last face-to-face session, but this is not the conclusion of this workplace communication course. So the last module will be released next week on Tuesday, which is email communication by Professor Varsha Apte, who has in fact been teaching this module for our own students. She is in fact also the head of our computer center here. So she has some very interesting stuff to share with you through her videos. Now what we plan to do is to have a short session where we want your comments and feedback on this workplace communication course as a whole, that is all the modules taken together. Non-verbal communication, the gender and diversity issues, workplace integrity, activities on meetings and professional conduct, all of these together. We would like to have your feedback on the three things that I've meant that you see on the screen. One is, what is your own takeaway? That is, what is it that you feel you have learned which you did not know before? So if you can give us some feedback on that, it will help us to improve these courses. Secondly, if you have any cribs, so crib is a popular term used in IIT. This is if you have any complaints to offer. So if you feel that something was not done properly, so the technical stuff we'll take care of, but about the content and the delivery, if you feel that there were some topics that were not covered or some things that were not clear or some things were too short or we did not explain some things properly, so please let us know. Okay, if you have any cribs about the way in which this course was conducted. And thirdly, any suggestions that you may have. Okay, any suggestions for improving this course in terms of new topics or the way in which we explain the examples, the activities, the quizzes and so on, please let us know. So the takeaways, the cribs and the suggestions. So we will be making this a short session for about half an hour or less. So if any of you have any feedback to give on these three points, please let us know. Okay, IERCM, welcome back.
My name is Gaurav Pandey. My question is, like, being an executive in a profession, like, I have a fear of losing the job, or I have a fear of not achieving the desired target by the company. So how can I overcome this fear?
Okay, so thank you.
What do you think?
Yeah, thank you. That's a very good question. Because all of us have this feeling of nervousness, especially at the beginning of a job, okay? And we all come with certain qualifications, and we've been selected to work in a company because we've gone through a tough selection process where your ability has been tested and you have been found to have certain qualities and merit because of which you've been selected. So, but then when you actually join the job, you find that the pressures are very high. You find that you have to do a lot of learning. You find that what you have learned in your education is not always appropriate for performing the job. So, two or three things you need to remember. One, always remind yourself that you are selected in a company because you're good. Okay? So, have confidence in yourself. So, even when you find that something is tough, something is not easy, that there are some things you're not able to do, remind yourself that you have the ability. Okay, that's what I did. 25 years ago when I finished my PhD, my first job was with an international UN organization. It was not easy for me. Okay, there were a lot of things I had to learn. I had to learn GIS, which I had never done before. Okay, I learned it by myself. So, a lot of things I had to learn by myself, but I was told that I was selected over several other people who were also interviewed for the job. So, I firstly felt that I had to stand up to that reputation that I had, which I showed during the selection process. Secondly, I had certain qualifications with me. I had to make use of that. So, I made sure that even though I was scared, I didn't know certain things, I made it a point to learn, to work day and night so that I could fulfill those obligations. Okay. The second thing is learning on the job is also an important thing. Okay. So, you use your own abilities when you go to work. But beyond that, it's very important that you are constantly learning on the job. So, you cannot say that this is not something I know, don't know, and therefore, I will not do this job. That will not work in any organization today. Okay. If you don't know something, you have to learn. So, be prepared to learn. If you do these things, then it is almost difficult for an employer to lose you. Okay. But if you still fear that there is a chance that you will lose your job, that you will not be able to perform up to the expectations, the best thing is to go and talk to some seniors. Because many organizations these days tend to appoint a mentor who is a senior for junior staff members. Go and talk to them, tell them these are your fears, how best can I overcome these? Okay. So, once you, or you can speak to an HR person in your company and they will advise you on what can be done. Alright? Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for asking that question.
So, suppose I have an idea and I have thrown that idea in a meeting and to my higher authority, and that person has taken that idea and showed up that this is my idea. Like, he has stolen my idea.
Yeah.
So, in that situation, what should I do?
Yeah. So, this is something that happens, and I've had some students also talking to me about this when they were working in a company before joining IIT. So, it's always very important that you ensure that whatever your contribution is to a particular idea or an innovation or a technology is acknowledged. Because these days we all take copyrights and intellectual property rights very seriously. Everybody needs to be acknowledged for the work they do, for the ideas they come up with. So, if somebody steals your idea or does not acknowledge your own contribution, you need to make sure it is brought up with higher functionaries. So, if some higher authorities don't listen to you, take it up with others. Take it up at a still higher level, maybe with the board of the company, okay? Or talk to other colleagues and make a joint representation. One of the things you need to make sure is that whenever you have an idea and you float it to the higher authorities, make sure there is a trace, there is a record. So, you can send it by email, for example. Don't just give it orally, because then later on you can claim that this is the date on which that idea was given, or give it on a piece of paper and get an acknowledgement for it. So, making sure that there is a paper trail or an electronic trail for an idea ensures that nobody can steal your idea, or even if they do, you can file a claim for it and ensure that you fight for your rights. Okay. So, what I would like to request also again is that this is for the entire workplace communication course. So you need not restrict your questions only to professional conduct. You can, I would like you to give general feedback, like I mentioned in the beginning, general feedback on what you have taken away from this course. If you have any specific comments or suggestions or complaints, please let me know. If you want to include some topics or elaborate, clarify some topics, please let us know. Or if you feel something has not been dealt with properly, please let us know. So we would like to have feedback for the entire workplace communication course. Okay, K.S. Rangaswamy, you have been giving us a lot of questions today. Thank you for all those questions via chat. So K.S. Rangaswamy is saying that the workplace and soft skill training gave us a better transition from college to corporate, and we thank the entire team for the great effort. Karthik Subramaniam, I am assuming that he is the coordinator. Thank you very much for acknowledging your efforts, and we wish your students all the best in transitioning from college to a job in the corporate sector. School of Management Sciences.
Sir, first of all, I want to thank you for this nice workshop, College to Corporate. Sir, our participants are doing so many things regarding the assignments and quiz, and we are helping them to have a good score in this College to Corporate program.
Okay.
Let me give the mic to a student so that you also can have a feedback of this course.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. My name is Himanshu Singh. Mm-hmm. And I am highly thankful for the certification code you have provided to us. We have learned a lot from all the syllabus and completed the quiz, so many tasks, and I have performed so many practicals related to the topics you have provided in the quiz.
So is there any suggestion that you have? Do you think we can improve on some area? Anyone else? Okay. I think we'll move to another center. Thank you. Thank you for the appreciation.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for giving this opportunity. And we have learned a lot relevant to soft skills and workplace communication. So these are all the new things and for us, and really very helpful for transition from college to corporate. And thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you for providing this course. It was very useful for us, and the students, we here are pre-final years, and so it was very useful for us to appear for forthcoming placement sessions, and the presentations provided by various presenters were so useful, and it was valuable for us, and thank you for providing this course, and we are expecting this course in the near future too. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. We are very happy that this was useful for you. So our whole objective was to provide you these courses right before your placement, so that this transition from college to corporate becomes as smooth as possible for all of you. And we would like to wish all of you all the best for the coming placements. So I don't see any specific feedback or comments from any of the centers, so I think there are some three colleges. Walchand, can we go to Walchand?
I'm Chandan Jain. Mm-hmm. So my question is that if we are working in an organization and we are given a job by our superior, which is a monotonous job and will not help us, or we cannot flourish through that, mm-hmm. like going to a certain place or attending something or do something.
Yeah, yeah.
So that gives a kind of frustration, and which builds on. So how to cope up with that kind of frustration?
Yeah. So I can understand this, because not all jobs are exciting all the time. A lot of the work is often monotonous. Okay. So even my own director tells me this when I say that I don't have time for doing more interesting things. He says, but you do have to do a lot of clerical work also. Okay. So a lot of work is exciting in the long term, but in the short term, many of us have to do this kind of monotonous work which is not really very exciting. So there are two responses that I would like to give you. One is, any job that you do, you will have to learn to cope with some of the very regular routine monotonous things that are attached to a particular work. Even if you are a rocket scientist, there's still a lot of nut and bolt job that you have to do. It's not exciting. Okay, though there is a lot of high science also. So one is getting used to that. The second is, if you feel that you have a lot of ideas, there's a lot more interesting stuff you do, you can do, but you are not being given an opportunity. So go up to the team leaders and tell them that you are capable of doing this, that you would like to do something more interesting, more useful. Okay. So usually it's because team supervisors, leaders are so busy, they have too many tasks, sometimes they do not even realize the capabilities of the staff and how they can make the job more interesting. So try and speak to your supervisors and leaders and ask them to give you more exciting, interesting, innovative jobs. But if that is still the case, where certain organizations have work which is completely monotonous, there is very little exciting, interesting stuff to do, then it's better you find an organization where you have a better fit. Because different people have different expectations from the job. Okay. So, you know, there was this Salman Khan movie called Kick, where they want to get a kick out of everything. Okay. That's also a very dangerous thing, to try and get a kick, to live your life like that. Okay. But it's also very important that you keep yourself motivated, for which you need to get a kick out of things. Okay. So, try to find an optimum balance where an organization will give you those opportunities. Okay. But if you expect that everything that you do will not be monotonous, will be exciting, then that's not possible. You have to learn to cope with the monotonousness of certain jobs also. Okay. Yeah. Thanks for asking that question. Thanks.
Thank you, sir. Yeah.
Sir, so I would like to thank you and your team on behalf of our college. It was very useful for the workplace that we got the lessons. Even in fact, now some days back, Infosys had come, so our seniors have managed very well. So thank you very much, and we are seeing much videos and interactions from you as soon as possible.
Thank you. Thank you for that appreciation, and we are very happy that whatever we are offering you is useful.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much. MGM's College of Engineering, Nanded.
Yeah, good evening, sir. This is Shiv Prasad, Course Coordinator, Workplace Communication 1192. Mm-hmm. Thank you for the efforts that you have taken for conducting this course. Mm-hmm. Long back, since 2 months, we'll be doing the assignments, solving the quizzes, attending your sessions and all. It has been seen that a lot of efforts that you put in behind this into happen this kind of activity. Thank you for the same from our institute. Yeah. But the one thing that we have realized, and I think that's a genuine part that I should share with you, if I'm not sharing, I'll be failing in my duty, mm-hmm. is what, while attending the face-to-face sessions, right, the students lose concentration in attending, in focusing on the screen. Mm-hmm. This is especially when you are interacting with the other remote centers. Mm-hmm. The students here lose the concentration. Mm-hmm. What could be the reason behind it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thank you for that question. In fact, this is the reason for having these face-to-face interaction. In fact, we were just talking about it during the break, because a lot of times when a course is completely online, students do tend to lose focus, do tend to lose concentration, which is why we try and keep the video length to about 10 to 15 minutes, because beyond that, it becomes very difficult. So we feel that through this interaction, there will be some personal touch where we are actually interacting with specific students and colleges. Now, we have achieved one step here where we are able to reach out to some colleges, because it's not possible for us to reach out to all 250, 300 colleges. But then when we are talking to one particular college, so the other students tend to switch off because they feel that they are not being directly involved. They are not being directly addressed. Okay, so this is where the motivation has to come from the students themselves, that what we are trying to say, even though I may be responding to a student from another place, from another center, it is of relevance to them. Okay, the reason why we are broadcasting it not only to all the centers but also through YouTube is that we feel that these questions are of a general interest to students beyond the person who is asking it. So that is something that we have to tell the students, that you may have a very specific question to which you want an answer, but sometime in the future the question raised by other students also will be faced by all of us. So once they realize that, they will start paying more attention to the questions and responses of other centers also. Okay, so as coordinators and teachers, we have to impress this upon students.
125 yep. students registered. If you look behind me, there are four students attending till the end of the day.
Yeah.
And I was asking early morning, it is why that you are not attending the session? Because we, when they registered, we made the compulsory that you should register for the program because this is very useful for you for getting placement and all other things. But when they are not attending, I was asking them. So almost all they have told the same answer. Yeah. That they are not able to concentrate. I mean, this
I see.
I don't know how to work on that, but this is the thing, this is what the feedback which I would like to give to you.
So, what I would suggest is we will, because this is a serious issue and we will take it up for discussion. All these students, those who are present and those who are absent, please ask them to give this feedback in the survey form. So, earlier, Professor Fatak mentioned that all students, it is compulsory to fill up the survey form. This particular feedback that they are not able to concentrate on the screen, please ask them to mention it and we will discuss and see if we can come up with a solution to this.
One more thing that we realized is when you're talking from your end, right, and the speaker is enthusiastic to speak, the people are concentrating.
Yeah.
But when you're communicating with the other centers, students lose the interest.
Yeah, no,
I'm sorry to say that, but this is what has happened.
No, I understand your problem.
But
I don't have an immediate solution, but we will definitely discuss it.
Exactly. But the efforts and the kind of videos that you have and the kind of quizzes that you are taking, that's absolutely commendable.
Thank you.
A lot of efforts that you put. Thank you for that.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
I mean, this is what we work for. DKT.
Yes. Sir, on behalf of my college DKT, I want to thank you for the workplace that you are conducting. And I also the videos that you uploaded on the website that are very much helpful for us because the small things also are considered in this that we are not considering.
Yeah.
And we are leaving that outside. We will neglect it. But they are very much important to us.
Okay.
It is very much good platform, sir. Small towns and villages, students are also getting to the new courses.
Thank you.
Sir, I have one suggestion, sir. Mm-hmm. The videos that you have uploaded should be made available for the download because the link is not specified for the download.
Sorry, I didn't get you. You said the videos need to be uploaded where?
Sir, on the website,
Where
we see that video, sir, you only give the link so we can download it for the further use.
Sir, they want to download the videos. I think that will be difficult because there are a lot of a lot of analytics, but also legal issues, copyright issues. So you can register and view the videos on the on site. I think they can do it even after the course is over, isn't it? Yeah, you can do it even after the course is over. Anytime you want, you can go and view these videos. But download, I think, will be a problem because of various other technical and legal issues. Okay. Yeah.
But the effect of moving pictures is very much helpful for the mind.
Okay. So thank you for those comments.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Especially, the point that you made about all the small things, because that has been our effort also to identify all the big and small issues that students are likely to face and then incorporate them in the course. Okay, so if you have any further points that you would like us to include, please let us know through the feedback. Yeah, thank you. Go ahead.
Sir, I want to share the feedback of this program, sir. Mm-hmm. Personally, sir, I want to salute and thank you to you from with the behalf of my college and my colleagues that you have provided us a college to corporate program which help us to take knowledge which doesn't teach us in our classroom.
Mm-hmm.
Means knowledge which you have provided us by the this college to corporate program we could not learn from our classroom. means it is observed by me that if I do not attend this college to corporate program, so I would not be able to know such a thing, means many of doubt in classroom, like assignment questions before before second interaction. I have also asked one question to you about assignment. You have given me optimizable solution that what should I do that time of assignment when I have get a deadline. So I thought that many of the solutions, means many of the problems which I was facing in my classroom in my mind personally, has solved by this college to corporate programs, like college means workplace communication and some soft skills, videos and which and the information which you have provided to us.
Okay, thank you. In fact, that's our objective also, that it's not just used for a situation where students go and get into the corporate sector, but it should be used in larger context also. So I'm glad you're able to use it in your college also. In fact, you know, many of us, the faculty and the staff here, we always think that you people are more lucky because we never got to attend a course like this. So we have to struggle through all of this. We have to learn these things on the job. So you are, you know, I'm glad that you people are having an opportunity to have a course like this, which sort of fast tracks you when you move to the corporate sector or to a job in the professions. Okay, so thank you for those comments.
Good afternoon, sir. Yes. I am Arun Kumar Verma. Sir, this is my suggestion. We must increase the number of questions in a quizzes, because my lots of friends perform the quiz or complete the quiz in the last date. If we increase the number of questions, okay, they will concentrate on the whole of the content material.
Okay.
And most of my friends complete not read the material, just go with the questions. So we must increase the difficulty level in the questions also.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you. See, the point about the quizzes is that it's not to really get you high marks or to test your abilities. It is just to make sure that you see the videos and recall the important contents. But we take your point that we do need to increase the number of questions and difficulty levels. However, we have received the opposite kind of feedback also, that some people feel that since they are doing these modules along with their existing courses, having more questions will make it difficult. But I think we have to strike an optimal level. So we'll take your feedback and see if we can give additional non-mandatory quizzes which can be made more difficult and also more questions for those students who are more serious about learning. Thank you.
So my name is Ankit Tripathi. Mm-hmm. So my question is about workplace communication. So my question is, as we learn so many technologies and languages and we get job in companies, so at any instant, if we get any task or if we get any project which follows technology with we are not familiar with, so what should we do? Yeah. Should we ask the superior to give some time, or should we quit it?
Yeah, that's a good question, because any organization you join, particularly these days, you know, this would not be the case 20 years or 30 years ago. So today's organization is constantly evolving, technology is constantly evolving, all the time new things are coming up. So it's very important we keep up to date with these technologies as well as new techniques, new rules and regulations. It could be new ways of doing something, new kinds of forms, accounting systems and so on. So usually what happens is, when something new is introduced, companies provide training to staff on that particular issue. Also, if some students, candidates are selected to work in a company and they do not have skills in a particular area, companies try to initially provide some training or some mentoring and guiding by seniors. So despite all this, if you still feel that you lack skills in something, the best thing is to ask that you be provided training in this so that you can then perform better. Okay. The other thing is, today there are a lot of opportunities for learning things by yourself. online, there is a lot of material. So you can always go online or register yourself for online courses and try to learn. So IIT Bombay itself, apart from these MOOCs courses, we have something called NPTEL, National Program on Technology Enabled Learning. So under NPTEL, we have courses on almost every topic from management to engineering to mathematics, science, social science, humanities, all of these topics. So the opportunities for learning are immense. But if you want some very specific skills, please do ask the office people to help you out to acquire those skills, and then so that you can perform better. Yeah.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening.
Good evening, sir. I am a pastor and I am working here as a trainer. Mm-hmm. Question in my mind is related to if we are doing the efforts, but we are not getting as much credit we should get. So what to do then?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that is something that happens, that you put in a lot of effort, but you don't get the credit. So you need to analyze what is the reason for not getting credit. Is it because you're not being appreciated? Is it because you're not visible? Is it because somebody doesn't personally like you or prefer your work style or prefer somebody else? So you need to try and find out whether it is lack of communication, because sometimes people put in effort but it is not recognized because that person is not adequately claiming credit for it. So in the previous session, Professor Zele was saying that you need to acknowledge the help that somebody else has provided to you. It's also equally important that you claim credit and recognition for what you do. Okay, so not to push yourself, but when it comes to meetings where work is being discussed, you should try to subtly bring out your own knowledge on a particular topic. So don't push it by saying that I did this, but you can always talk about the expertise, the skills that you and the knowledge that you have on a particular piece of work. So gradually people will know that you are capable in a particular area. Also, offer your own help voluntarily to others on areas you are comfortable with. Okay, if somebody is struggling with some work, if somebody doesn't know how to do it, you try to help them out. So these are ways in which gradually your own contribution will get recognized. Okay, but there will be a few companies where some people will try to hog the limelight all the time. Some people will not like to give credit to others. So it's always very important in such cases to talk to your leaders or to talk to the HR people and say that, you know, you're not being appreciated enough. So it's amazing how much open communication will help, because sometimes it's just lack of communication. So once you make it felt that you're not being appreciated or recognized, something will be done out about it 90% of the time. Okay.
Very nice suggestion.
Thank you. Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much. So you're offering yourself as an intern to work with us, Karthik Subramaniam. Thanks. Yeah. If possible, we'll keep this in mind and maybe we can involve you. Many other colleges also have sent us notes of appreciation through chat, and we thank all of them. So we would like to work is more and salary is less. What should be done? Okay, this is your. That's always a tough question, no? Because all of us feel that we are not being paid enough. Okay, no salary is enough for any of us, whatever we are paid. Okay, and these days we work in workplaces where all of us are always overworked. Okay, but salary doesn't go up even if you do more work. Okay, so. The things are a little different in the private sector, because in the public sector salaries are fixed, whereas in the private sector you can always negotiate more depending on how much work you do. Okay, so if you feel that you are overworked but not paid adequately, you can always negotiate. You can always claim that you are doing the work of two people, three people, you are doing the work of your leaders, of your superiors and so on, and therefore you should be paid. What usually happens in the private sector is that a person who does more work is noticed, and that person moves up the ladder quite fast. In good companies with good work ethics, good human resource management, work is always appreciated, and there is a, they are put on a track where they get promotions, they can go get to higher levels, they are given leadership positions and so on. So it depends on what kind of work you are doing. Okay, so you need to ask yourself also whether I am just being given a lot of mundane work which is not meaningful to me, which is not contributing much to the organization, where I don't get to learn much. So that is not really useful for you, and you should try to either get into a track in the organization where you are doing much better work, or you move to a different organization. But if you are doing work which you like to do, and you are being given additional responsibilities, usually it will get appreciated and you will be given higher positions with higher salaries in the private sector. But if it is still not happening, the best thing, as I mentioned in the previous, in response to the previous question, is to talk it over with your HR people and your leaders, that this is what is happening, that you are not being appreciated for the work you are doing. Okay, keep an open channel of communication saying that you deserve more in terms of the contribution you are making to your organization. Okay, but it's not always possible, because in some organizations the salaries tend to be quite fixed. Okay, so we've gone through a very range of responses, and we've also received some comments for feedback, which we will take quite seriously and discuss it among our team and see how we can improve our modules and presentation in future courses. Do send us other feedback also. It doesn't all have to be positive, so we are not so egoistic here. Okay, we do like some negative feedback, because we want to constantly improve ourselves also. So if there are some problems, technical problems, content related problems, please do let us know. Alright, and I would like to conclude the session here, because today many students could not join us because they are in the middle of their exams, they are having other activities, and many colleges are also having technical problems. So do send us feedback on all the modules. Do make sure that you fill up the survey forms for feedback, because these are taken quite seriously here, and we do try to make improvements all the time. We would like to conclude by saying that please maximize the opportunities for learning that you have got from these courses. We put in a lot of effort, and we hope it's been very useful for you, and we would like to wish you all the best for the upcoming placements, and we hope you all get into good positions very soon. Thank you very much.